and that is how we can hit some pretty good golf shots. So here we're gonna go into the topic of how much knee flex, or what should our knees do at P1. Here's what I like to see. If I'm standing straight up and down just like this, this would be my legs completely, completely straight. I want to unlock my knees over my shoelaces. So if we were to measure that in degrees, I'm unlocking my knees probably 10 degrees. So this would move from 180 down to 170. Okay, so we're only losing about 10 degrees of knee flex. Now again, remember this, inside of here, every action that you have is going to have a reaction. So if I start here with 10 degrees of flex, it allows me to turn and keep my height up so that I can start to leverage the ground more. Now let's go into somebody who has more knee flex. So I start down here where I've got, let's say, 30 degrees of knee flex. One, for me to complete my turn, I have to stand up out of it. It's gonna change my balance parameters, which is gonna throw off contact, in my opinion. Here's the other thing. Even if this guy can complete his turn here, what does this want to do? The more that I'm flexed into the ground, this is not comfortable. It wants to get out of the ground. So this is where we start to see people. We go here, we turn, and we jump early. And like we saw there, we get a lot of thin shots, or it might be heavy shots, because we're constantly trying to time up with throw, up with throw. It's a really difficult way of swinging the club timing-wise, in my opinion. So where I want to see you again, we're right here. This is straight up and down. I'm unlocking my knees over my shoelaces right there. And that's all I need to see in your knee flex at P1. And then we've got room where we're in balance and we can be mobile.